perhaps the biggest offense to our scientific advancement so far is that we are still have 5 billion people living with no or limited access to electricity. These individuals experience shorter lifetimes marred with time-stealing, laborious tasks that can be easily done by electricity. So providing a universal energy access is not only a moral imperative for us engineers, but it delivers substantial socioeconomic and political benefits. Realizing this requires to double the global power capacity to 30 terawatts, considering population growth by 2050. On the other hand, humanity is jeopardized by climate change. The Arctic sea ice extent is in a record low state, the blue line on the diagram, and the Arctic temperature is an insane 30 degrees Celsius warmer. These numbers form the most formidable and fundamental challenge of our century, to stay within the 2-degree average global temperature rise, as the historic Paris Agreement states, that requires flipping the share of clean energies to 85% of a double global power demand. So here is where my research is focused on microgrids, a cluster of generators that bring energy to local loads, such as communities with no electricity. Operating microgrids is challenging, though, because the number of generators is considerably less than a large-scale system. So any single unit can have a large influence on the load generation balance by changing its operating output. Therefore, microgrids tend to rely on predictable but carbon-emitting diesel engines rather than unpredictable but local clean and renewable energies, unless there is an expensive, fast-responsive battery with a comparable capacity to compensate for renewables. But not every closed door is locked. I theorize that in microgrids, the small-scale system and the load generation proximity would allow for a fast control of load voltages all over the system. Based on this, and using the load voltage sensitivity, I propose a controller that compensates for fluctuation in renewable energies by manipulating the load's consumption through mathematically tuned voltage set points of generators. I also propose a secondary control that calculates the efficient operating point of generators by predicting their behavior in presence of renewable energies. The overall control schemes would allow for 15% saving in investment cost through reducing the need for battery capacity and 15% reduction in fuel consumption and greenhouse emissions by enabling a higher penetration of renewable energies, and they require no hardware investment. I collaborated with industry, implemented these controllers in practice, and obtained a promising performance. So as Walter wisely quotes, no problem can withstand the assault of sustained thinking. And I'm confident that with the help of my research and others in all related disciplines, we can successfully overcome the barriers to a sustainable, universal energy system on which the future of humanity depends. Thank you.